Okay, so here we have our toad garden that we have made. We made it by a flower bush because the flowers will attract insects, and the toads like to eat insects, so that's good for the toads, and it looks really pretty. Here we have some terracotta flower pots. Toads like to hide under those, so it's a good idea to put those in your garden. Let's see. Some bricks and wood for architectural interests. Not really any other use. There's a little bowl that we have planted into the ground so that it'll attract bugs too, and the toads can cool off if they want. They can jump in there and they could get out back out really easily. There's the flower bush. Here's a cinder block. Now my little sister loves fairies, and she says that this is the fairy apartment so the fairies can visit the toads, and it looks really pretty if you have any extra birdhouses or shells or plants to put on top. There's a little toad hidey hole in there. I don't think there's any in there. No, not in there at the moment, but there could be eventually. Some more flower pots, some flowers. Let's see.
This is what I made.
There's a little flower pot castle that my brother made. He decorated it with flowers and moss. Here we have a sandcastle mold, just for fun, make it look pretty. Let's see, we have another flower pot. See, a little teepee made of wood so toads can hide under it, but there's none under there at the moment, but there will be eventually. It's still a little cold outside for toads. Behind it we have a big pile of leaves, and there's a couple reasons why we have that big pile of leaves. That's because the leaves will attract bugs, again, as they're rotting, and toads will like to eat bugs, so that's another good thing for the toads. And when the weather's hot, or if there's predators around like snakes or birds, and the toads can hide under the leaves. Yep. And we have stuck some sticks in the ground just to kind of separate the leaf pile from the apartment, the cinder block apartment. Some more seashells around here, some bricks. We made a little path of grass to walk on, more for aesthetic pleasure than anything else. And just a little decoration with some rocks. It's not completely finished, but the toads would like to live in it, and yep, that's that. So that's our toad garden.